Jerry Explores History. Today we're going to look at the election of 2016. That's been covered to death. We're going to look at something really cool from it. So, Donald Trump, now president, beat Hillary Clinton in 2016. The way the American electoral system works, everyone casts their votes, all the citizens, and then every state has electors representing its electoral votes who will officially cast their ballots.
When people cast their vote, they are actually voting for a group of people called electors. The number of electors each state gets is equal to its total number of senators and representatives in Congress. A total of 538 electors form the Electoral College. Each elector casts one vote following the general election. The candidate who gets 270 votes or more wins.
What's to prevent the elector representing an electoral vote from casting for the wrong person? There really isn't anything in the Constitution that says what happens if he or she doesn't do it. So we've had many, many cases, including one explored on this channel, where someone called a faithless elector, basically someone that doesn't cast the vote for the person that the people he or she's supposed to represent voted for. In 2016, it happened. In fact, Colin Powell wasn't even running, but three people voted for Colin Powell, three electors. So officially, Colin Powell got three votes, even though he didn't even run. But today we're going to explore the one vote in Washington state that was given to a Native American. This was the first electoral vote in a presidential election ever given to a Native American. The person of interest is Faith Spotted Eagle. I'm going to attempt to pronounce your name. Takun Inajinwin, I believe, or Thukan, I'm so sorry, Thunkan Inajinwin, I'm so sorry if I pronounced it wrong. She's a Yaktun Sioux, part of the Yaktun Sioux Nation. Remember, in 2016, the Keystone XL pipeline and the Dakota Access Pipeline, there was a lot of protests. She was one of the activists. The person who voted for her, the elector in Washington State, the faithless elector, his name was Robert Setiakum Jr., and he is also a political and environmental activist, and he's also a Native American. So he was an ardent Bernie Sanders supporter, and he, like many Bernie supporters, felt like the Democratic Party, the Democrats, purposefully blocked Bernie from getting the nomination. And that's why Hillary ran and lost to Trump. Satyakam said if Hillary won the state, he was not going to vote for Hillary. He said it, and many people thought he'd vote for Bernie, but it was a last-minute decision. While he was casting his vote, he started writing a B, but then doing the second part of the B, and then starting to look like an F. And he said, oh, I'll vote for Faith Spotted Eagle instead. It just seems right. So that's what happened. He casted his vote for Faith Spotted Eagle. I was looking online to see, I think every state has its own legal procedure to deal with faithless electors. I believe, at least according to the LA Times article, it's a $1,000 fine if you don't vote for the person you're supposed to vote for as an elector. You could screw up the election and only get fined $1,000. The beauty of the Electoral College system, right guys? This was a very funny, but very interesting, and something we have to address part of American politics, and we got to see it in play in 2016 during the presidential election. In fact, guys, there were three other Washington state electors who also broke ranks and didn't vote for Clinton. Remember how I said that there were three votes for Colin Powell? All three were cast in Washington state. Man, we got to go to Washington state and talk to those people. They seem to have a mind of their own. You know, they don't want to vote the way their people in the state voted. The three that voted for Colin Powell were Brett Chiafalo, Levi Guerra, and Esther John.
We took a position that is very important in our process, and we owe it to the American people to do what we believe in this situation. And if what you believe is that Donald Trump is unfit to be president, you need to stand up and say that and do it. And on the opposite side of that, I will do whatever I can to help protect you. Any elector is welcome to contact me. And we have security planning going on to address some of these issues. And I would be happy to assist in any way I could with any elector who has security concerns.
And guys, let's be honest, Colin Powell probably would have been a really good president. But he didn't run, people! We gotta respect the democratic process here. Okay, this was a short one. Jerry Explores History, out.
For me, the Electoral College is something that we need, but it's something that needs to be improved on to be able to represent the citizens of our country properly.